Single. The next award is for the Kimpro Platinum Standard for Education. It was introduced in the year 2015. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to announce our 11th Kimpro Platinum Standard for Education, Dr. Mithu Alur.
Dr. Mithu Alur is the founder chairperson of ADAPT. And what does ADAPT stand for? Able, disabled, all people together. Formerly known as the Spastic Society of India. For over 40 years, Dr. Alur has been deeply involved in the education, healthcare, and employment of children with disability. She believes in the holistic development of children and recognizes that the mind and the body need to work in tandem. To Dr. Alur, cerebral palsy means an intelligent mind trapped in a disobedient body, so well put. Consequently, she believes the education and health of such children are inextricably linked. Both need nourishment for quality and well-being of a child. Her daughter is disabled. Dr. Alur, a pioneer with a robust will. At the state level, Dr. Alur has been involved in community-based projects involving state and municipal authorities, non-government agencies, the private sector, and international agencies. ADAPT's first model has been replicated in 16 states of India. Dr. Alur, an untiring missionary. The service delivery framework of ADAPT, designed by Dr. Alur herself, includes identification, assessment, education, and treatment of children with development disorders, infant clinics for babies, and vocational training units for young adults. ADAPT children have progressed in life to become, hold your breath, lawyers, accountants, business persons, librarians, and more. Some have even earned a PhD qualification. Dr. Alur, delivering quality, but more importantly, delivering dignity. In the area of pedagogy, Dr. Alur has initiated a course in collaboration with the Institute of Child Health London, which reaches out to master trainers in the Asia-Pacific region. The Community Initiatives and Inclusion course is in its 15th year and trained more than 200 master trainers in India, in Pakistan, in Sri Lanka, Nepal, Bangladesh, China, Mongolia, Vietnam, Cambodia, Indonesia, Tajikistan, Tonga. The list is quite formidable. Dr. Alur, making India proud, making every one of us proud. Let's salute Dr. Mithu Alur, our Kimpro Platinum Standard Award winner 2015 for education.
May I request Mr. Jagdish Kapoor and Mr. Suresh Malla to do the honors.
My dream is to fly over the rainbow.
Good evening, friends and recipients of this prestigious award. Roger has actually said everything, so He's left very little for me to say. But I would just like to say at the outset that I would like to congratulate the Quimpro Foundation, Mr. Lula, and all the eminent trustees and colleagues who have given us this opportunity of all of us being here together to hear about Quimpro. And it really makes me feel terribly humbled. And thank you all very much for giving me this prestigious award. And I just want to say that awards, I do believe, are useful in not just individually focusing on a person, but really on a collective team of people who have made this journey. And I have here with me some of the trustees and colleagues, they're all sitting over there, who have made this journey with me and who have given of themselves in an invisible manner, steadfastly, committedly, in service of the nation. So I take this opportunity to pay a tribute to them, and I say that this award is for you all. I just said journey because we started off with a small school, actually. In fact, Roger reminded me that he'd been there right from the beginning, and which is true. But it soon became so big that we had to build institutions because there was so little about disabled people. And that institutions just became a movement, a very important movement for disabled people in the country. Of course, the reason, as many of you may know, but some of you may not, was a selfish one because my own daughter was disabled. I've had to wear many hats, but I think I much prefer the hat that I've worn of a mother. But initially in the early 60s, nothing was known about disability. And we were just 22 and 24. In fact, my husband was in Tatas. And we just, they helped us a lot. And we went from pillar to post trying to get treatment for Malini. But they always said, oh, Malini is going to be a vegetable. Brain damage is incurable, irreversible. And this, well, we were privileged enough to be able to go to London. And there the whole approach is different. And they assessed her, and it was exactly the opposite of what India had said, that that she was going to be a vegetable. But they found her to be above average in intelligence. And because of their not only just compassionate approach, but sort of treating Malini equally, you know. And I think it made a big difference to Malini and her mother. And so I started studying about neurology and this neurological insult, and especially about intelligent mind in a disobedient body. And now, of course, you'll be happy to know that Malini has been able to do two masters, and she's sitting there on a wheelchair and is now, we're very proud of this, is now working with TCS, Tata Consultancy Services in London, and holding her role for the last 3 years. And of course, there was nothing she was getting here. We had not even reached that stage here where people would give her that opportunity. And since she had the right to be employed in London, she got this particular job. So the thing is, when we came back to India after England, there was still nothing. And most people said, why do you want to get them educated? Because we haven't achieved universal education yet. And even the health minister, he said that, are you talking about plastics? You know, like he didn't know the jargon terms, plastic. And So, and it just drove one to a complete outrage. And that is how in 1972 we started the Spastic Society of India, now called ADAPT, in Afghan Church. But since then it has grown immensely. It's one of the largest charities in the country, lots of centers and schools. And we've been also nationally able to incubate services right throughout the country. So it is true that we have a national presence, and we'll be happy to know that 28 of the 31 states have got a Spastic Society, and this unique, for want of a better word, and innovative model, which combines education and treatment under one roof, away from a hospital setting to a special school setting, because you're dealing with a longitudinal brain damage, a chronic one that goes on forever. And since then, I think what nationally we found is that there were many who were captured, their imagination got captured by this particular model, and many went out all over the world and got studied, many of the close friends and family, and so that's how it all spread to 28 of the 31 states. So that was the first model, and working in this area of darkness, one really was amazed with our own beneficiaries and stakeholders, because we didn't realize that just with a little modification, they were all going to be, as Raj mentioned, accountants, journalists, doctors, computer experts. And I'm very proud to say that I've got parents here, Professor Sitanshu Mehta. Can you just stand up? He's a double Fulbright scholar. And Mrs. Mehta, Anjani Mehta. And their child was my first student. And she has now got also a PhD. And is a great author. And you must have seen today in the Indian Express that a boy who has cerebral palsy is just also finishing the PhD. So it has had a tremendous ripple effect and a great impact, but it was only in 1993 when I was invited by London School of Economics to be an academic visitor that I decided to study more. And I got, through my doctoral degree, I found that really India didn't have a cohesive policy for the disabled. So all disabled people were left out of the system. So it's a systemic exclusion, an institutional discrimination starting right from the top. So we began the next model, which was moving from segregated education to inclusive education. And we said they have to go to regular schools. And you know that it has been very difficult, but you'll be happy to know that we passed legislation. And today there's a right to education. And in that right to education, we have also included disabled children. Now, just to put those two words, including disabled children, it took us 45 years. But it's there. And it's a constitutional right, and it's a mandate. And if you don't allow us in, we'll see you in court. So, but what was very interesting is that it was the government who passed all this, but then they were not able to really implement it. So now the whole task of operationalizing the right to education is beginning. And of course, as again, Roger's taken everything out of my speech, and that is, it's spread to all of Asia. So no, nearly 22 countries of Asia is now moving towards inclusive education. I think that the last model is really concerns a lot of people here, and that is that the CSR of companies, they don't have disability in their framework. So that's something that we need to work together, you know. It's because if you don't have the disabled like you didn't have in the government, we will never get them employed. So that's my next battle. So I'd just like to conclude to say that it's been a spectacular journey for me. I have learnt much more than I have given. And it's not been a journey for money, not for prestige, not for power. But it has been the right to without getting into what are the fruits of one's, as the scriptures say, the right is to work only and not to the fruits. And I think we mustn't be complacent, but I'm reminded of Gandhiji, who said that a group of determined spirits fired by an unquenchable faith in their mission can alter the course of history. And I think perhaps in an incremental way, we have done that and put it on the bedrock of social justice and human rights. But we shouldn't be complacent, shouldn't be proud. And these are the meetings that humbles one, because that is what you need in service of India, because there's so many things that one has to do, and that one should not think of oneself, you know, it's the nation. So I invite you all to come with me in this spectacular journey. You will never regret it, because you'll be able to help wipe the tear from every mother's eye, and you will be helping to build a nation, an India that cares, an India that cares for the disabled, the poor, the needy, the impoverished, and beyond class, caste, religion, beyond political party. So thank you once again, every one of you, and namaskar.
Thank you for your words, Dr. Alur.